Good morning, students. Today we'll discuss the last class of the concentration and concentration of some points of concentration. Just to follow here, and just I'm explaining, and you concentrate on it. Already we have discussed the molarity and normality. And the next part is your molality. Molality means moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. That already we have discussed in the class 11. And little just briefing, and then if any question is coming on that, then you can solve it. M equal to, this small m, it is denoted moles of solute by mass of the solvent in kg. And one more term is called as the formality. Formality means number of gram formula mass of the solute present in 1 liter of the solution. That is formula mass of the solute by volume of the solution in liter. Formula mass means that it is in the any compound, that may be covalent compound or any compound it is, what the formula is coming on that, and that accordingly you will calculate the all total atomic mass, that equal to molecular mass is coming in that formula, and then volume of the solution in liter. Then mole fraction, this is another term of the concentration. Moles of that component divided by the total mass of all the components. That means, suppose we will take one of the component, suppose A and B, A having N1 moles and B having N2 moles, and total moles equal to N1 plus N2, then concentration of A in terms of moles fraction, then concentration of A, then concentration of A equal to what it will be, now N1 by N1 plus N2, this is called mole fraction of A. Similarly, of B concentration in the term of mole fraction equal to B equal to what it will be, now N2 by N1 plus N2, this is already you have studied in class 11, so little more you just to learn. Then mass fraction is what? One of the term that is called mass fraction. That means a particular component having quantity in mass divided by total mass of the substances. Just like as mass fraction equal to mass of the component divided by total mass of all the components. Suppose A having 10 gram and B having 20 gram. 10 plus 20, all total is coming 30 gram. Then mass fraction of A equal to 10 by 30, that equal to 1 by 3. Similarly, mass fraction of B equal to 20 by 30, you cut it by, you will get 2 by 3. So in this way, mass fraction is calculated. Then parts per million, parts by mass, ppm, we say, mass of that component in 1 million parts of the mass of all the components. That means all the components will take 1 million. From 1 million parts of that mass, all the components. 1 million part means how much quantity of that total mass that will be remain in denominator, and numerator part will be mass of the component. Parts per million, parts by volume. So volume of that component in 1 million part by volume of all the components, just like as mass. Similarly, strength. These parts all will be discussed, but discussed not, it will come in a practical. In practical, the strength we calculate, percentage by mass calculate, percentage by volume we calculate. So you learn it is strength equal to mass of the solute in gram by volume of the solution in liter. But it is 1 liter may, in 1 liter how much gram it is present. Yeah, total gram divided by total volume in liter. So percentage by mass equal to mass of solute in gram divided by mass of the solution in gram into 100. Total solute and solvent together, what much mass is coming, that you write in denominator, into 100 you will put. that is percentage by mass will come. Then percentage by volume I will get. Similarly, volume of the solute in ml by volume of the solution in ml into 100. Same way, the solute and solvent total solution volume is coming what you write in ml in the denominator, and your solute in ml that will be a denominator into 100. In 100 way, how much it quantity is coming. So these all are the important part of the concentration. And next, few relation that I am going to explain that you understand. Few relation. Okay, you write it. Okay. See. Few relation. In the relation, first of all, you understand the relation part, what is coming. Just to see. You know that one. Normality n equal to molarity, that is normality equal to normality n equal to molarity molarity into x factor, that is molarity into x factor, that implies n equal to m into x. Okay, so here x factor already we have discussed. X factor of atom is the valency, x factor of acid is basicity, x factor of base is acidity, and x factor of your salt is cationic charge or anionic charge, not together. Okay, next part is your normality equation. This is one of the part. Next part is your normality equation. In normality equation, basically, you can normality equation. What is the equation of normality equation? In this case, what you are getting? Normality equation equal to N1 into V1 equal to N2 into V2. What the question comes here? When the volume of a solution is changed to V2, understand? If V1 is changing to V2, how it is? Either you can change the solvent. Suppose water is added more, then V2 is changing. Volume, second final volume is coming different. So at that time, if the normal concentration is in N1, then what will calculate the, what is the value of N2? So in that way, you can calculate. If the question comes like this, like that way, you can solve. Second reason what? Your molarity equation. Molarity equation, what it will come? Molarity equation what? That equal to M1 into V1 equal to M2 into V2. Same, molar concentration is changed as per the volume changed. Suppose V1 it was, initially it is 100 ml and it becomes 200 ml. So in that case, concentration is changed. Okay. So, first it was something, then what is the molarity of a next time? That means, if the question is comes like this, for example, suppose first concentration molarity equal to your V1 equal to 100 ml and M1 equal to suppose 1 by 10. And then, what will be M2 kya hoga? And if 100 ml more water is added, what it will happen? Your answer will be what? You see, so you will apply this equation, M1 into V1, M1 into V1 equal to M2 into V2. M1 is coming 1 by 10 into V1 equal to 100. ml equal to m2 will calculate m2 v2 v2 is your coming 200, and then m2 will be what? Now this is your 10, this is coming 10, so 10 by 200 concentration decreases, that is 1 by 20 becomes, so m2 becoming 1 by 20. So in this way, this type of question is coming, you can calculate. And next final part is your what? Just to write down. Okay. And next final part is your what? When when two reactants are given, in that case what will happen? Suppose when two different reactants are given. When two different reactants are given, so at that time, what the relation of concentration will find? The relation of concentration will be what? Now, N1 into V1 divided by N1 equal to M2 into V2 divided by N2. So, here you can find three terms. So, any of the five terms will be given. 3 plus 3 is 6. Any of the five terms will be given, and sorry, any of the one term will be given to find out, and other five terms will be given in the question. In that case, you can calculate. This is the relation. So, using these relations, you will find out, you will solve some questions. At least when school will open, at least 20 questions from each relation. From each relation you will complete. You will do it and I will see it. And this is your homework for you. From normality, from molarity, and then from the concentration relation, that is from normal relation, molar relation, and then two reactant relations. Okay? So this is all about your concentration. And next video, I'll post by using vapor pressure and other components of the solution. So thank you.